The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah jalla wa ala sent azab, punishment, to the inhabitants of a place which numbered 18,000. There was a place which had 18,000 people in it, a city which had 18,000 people in it, and Allah jalla wa ala punished them. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said the worship was like the worship of the prophets. 18,000 people living in one city are being punished, but the worship was like the worship of the prophets, but they were still punished. Imagine a person's worship is like the worship of the prophets, but he's still punished. The companion said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how is that possible? Their worship was like the worship of the prophets, and they were still punished. And azab was sent from Allah jalla wa ala. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, they did not express anger for the sake of Allah, and they did not invite people towards good and forbidden evil. They were just worried about their own worship. My Quran, my wazaif, my awrad, my recitation, my nawafil, my fasting. They did not give dawah in the path of Allah. Because of that, 18,000 people were being punished. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all of them, azab of Allah jalla wa ala came to them. This is why it's important. We act upon these 12 points, but one of the most important points from these 12 points is, we will go out there and give dawah in the path of Allah. Another very beautiful hadith. Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala once asked, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is there any jihad other than the jihad with the disbelievers? Is there any jihad better than doing jihad against the disbelievers? Sayyidina Siddiq Akbar radiallahu ta'ala asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, yes, O Abu Bakr, the mujahids in the way of Allah are better than the martyrs. They're given provision and they are alive. They roam about in the world and Allah praises them before the angels. Jannah has been adorned for them. Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala asked, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who are these blessed people that Allah jalla wa ala praises them to his angels, and paradise is adorned for these people, and they are greater than the fighters in the path of Allah, they are greater than the mujahids, and they are greater than the martyrs. Who are these blessed people? Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala asked. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, they enjoin good and forbid evil. They are the ones who invite people towards good and forbid evil. They are greater than the mujahids. They are greater than the martyrs. They have taken the responsibility of inviting people towards good and forbidding evil. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, they walk about in the streets. Can you imagine this when you go and give dawah? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, they walk around in the streets, in the world. They roam about in the world. They walk around in the streets. These are the people who invite people towards good and forbid evil. Amiruna bil ma'ruf wa nahuna 'anil munkar. Those who give dawah towards good and forbid evil. Now listen to this. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then said, they love one another for the sake of Allah. They love one another for the sake of Allah. Meaning, when they go out and they invite people towards good and forbid evil, they love each other. They love the believers, and their love is not for themselves. Their love is not for their own benefit, their worldly benefit. It is only for the sake of Allah. They love each other for the sake of Allah. Just imagine this spectacle. When you go out to give dawah in the path of Allah, you are on the streets to invite people towards good and forbid evil, and you have love for each other. It is for the sake of Allah. These are the people that are being praised by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then the beloved of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, by the one in whose hand is my life, one of them will live in such a palace. One of them, meaning each da'i, each propagator of Islam, will live in such a palace, in such a palace on the day of judgment, in the hereafter, in Jannah, which is placed above all the palaces of the martyrs. The one who invites people towards good and forbids evil, each one of them will be placed in such a palace which is greater and placed above the palaces of the martyrs of Shuhada. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, each palace will have 300,000 doors. Each palace which will have 300,000 doors. Can you believe that? Three lock, 300,000 gates. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and each one will be made out of valuable jewels with green color, and every door will have lamps in it, will have lights in it. And then the Prophet said, in that palace, he will have 300,000 hoors, 300,000 beautiful women of Jannah, 300,000 hoors. And Rasulullah said, whenever a hoor will look at that person, whenever, imagine that 300,000 hoors in the palace of Jannah, it has 300,000 doors for who? The one who invites people towards good and forbids evil. The one who gives dawah in the path of Allah. And when the hoor will look at him, the hoor, what will the hoor say to that person? Whenever each hoor will look at that person who used to invite people towards good and forbid evil, the hoor will say, do you remember the day when you invited so and so in the path of Allah? Say subhanAllah, guys. The hoor will remind that person, do you remember when you were on Anamrak Road and giving dawah to people? Do you remember when you were on Stratford Road inviting people towards good? Do you remember when you argue with someone and telling him that this is the path of Ahlul Sunnati wal Jamaat, this is the path of Ahlul Haq, come to the gatherings? The hoor will remind that person, do you remember? This is the job of the hoor. The hoor will keep reminding that. Whenever the hoor will see that person, the hoor will remind, I have been given to you because of your dawah in the path of Allah. Subhanallah, subhanallah. This is the hadith of Rasulullah. This is why it's important. This is why we say, even whilst you're working on your tazkiyah, do not give up on dawah. Keep working on dawah, because this is an accepted act of worship.